Keep your subjects front and center with the amazing tracking effect in Reckon Bullseye. This product was created exclusively for Final Cut Pro. The presets are located in the Titles browser and in the Effects browser under Bullseye. The titles and effects are the same presets. They are designed for slightly different use cases. The versions in the Effect browser have access to the full resolution of the clip, while the titles only have access to the project resolution of the timeline. I'll drop Solo on the first clip. I'll go to the beginning of the effect on the timeline. In the parameters, we've got different modes where we track, set the pan and zoom, and show the final effect. At any time, you can click Show Documentation to get an on-screen guide to the plugin. Let's go to Set Tracker. I'll place the tracking square over the subject's head. There are tracking controls at the bottom. It's set to Track Position, but you can choose position and scale if the subject gets closer or further from the camera, thus changing scale in the picture and staying the same size. I'll click the Track Forward button. Next, we'll go to the Set Pan and Zoom mode. This does not show the final effect, just the positioning of the pan and zoom. I'll scrub through and see if there's any cropping going on. Then I can grab the green dot in the on-screen controls and move it to remove the cropping around the edges. I can further adjust the scale if I need to with the slider. There is a background blur setting that gives you a nice blur effect to bring more focus to the subject. I can tweak the blur radius and amount of blur. There are pan animation settings in this mode as well. More on that in a minute. When I go to the Show Effect mode, it shows the final effect. It cuts to a tight shot of the subject and tracks to his head during the shot and then cuts back, like there are two cameras on him. If I go back to the Set Pan and Zoom mode, I can set a pan effect and get start and end dots on screen. This will move the camera during the tight shot. I'll move the playhead to the beginning of the effect and adjust my start point. Then I'll move to the end of the effect and adjust the out point. I'll set the animation curve to quadratic in-out for a smooth pan. Plus, I'll check animation in and out, set the animation type to quadratic in-out, and set the duration to half a second. This gives us a build in and out animation. When I go to the Show Effect mode, I get a quick push in, a pan, and a pull out. That was super easy. Now that we have the basics down, let's drop the picture-in-picture effect on the next clip. The effect plugins go for the entire duration of the clip, so you'll need to use the blade tool if you want to make edits. I'll go ahead and track my subject. In the Set Pan and Zoom mode, there is a blue overlay that shows you what will be in our picture-in-picture window. In Set Picture-in-Picture mode, we can move our picture window with the on-screen controls. I can choose different shape options for the window. I have control over the look of the window frame and the line. I can add a drop shadow if I need to pop the window off the footage. Plus, I can adjust the duration of the animate in and out of the window. I'll go to the Show Effect mode to see my final look. Reckon Bullseye also includes separate effects, which give you tracked side-by-side and split-screen looks for your timelines. Reckon Bullseye is a unique and ingenious set of tracking special effects that will really add some action to your timelines. Try out a wide range of great audio and visual effects at fxfactory.com.